So hi, I'm Marilyn Orr, and...
Hi, I'm Bill Orr.
We're an international team that has arrived here in Texas as quick as we could. I'm from Canada. Bill's from Massachusetts.
Yes.
When we met online 11 years ago, we discovered we shared a dream for a wellness venue, and doing it here in Texas has a lot of benefits. So we came here 5 years ago to Austin looking for the right piece of land, fell in love with Wimberley, partly because of the resilience of the people and partly because of their focus on the environment. And so as part of our wellness center, we have built this amazing yurt that we love. And we want to give you a tour.
Ready. Welcome to the yurt.
This is a 30-foot yurt. It's about 706 square feet. Bill and I had fun designing this yurt. It was a game for us, figuring out the floor plan. So essentially, there are six rooms, quote unquote, in the yurt. So we'll take you to each of them. When you first come in the front door, to your right over here, we call the library. This is kind of artificial because our walls are curtains. But we do have, a nice space here with lots of fun books and games and nice dishes. These chairs recline. Let me demonstrate. So just a fun spot to just hang, chill, have a good conversation. Next, we have the living room. So this room here, obviously TV, no cable, because we want you connecting with nature when you're out here. But we do have some limited Apple stuff. These Moroccan poofs we have loved for tiny spaces because they instantly become tables, however you want to use them. So that was a learning curve, learning how to use a small space really effectively. And throughout the yurt, you'll see lots of art. Some of it's art from family, some of it's art from friends, local Wimberley people contributed art. Really important to us that you know, you're enjoying the outside beauty, but also artist beauty. So we wanted to make sure that a lot of people could enjoy the yurt at the same time. We have had families with 4 kids in here. That's so fun. So this is a sofa bed, converts to a queen. We've also used this space a number of times for massage. So massage therapists will come in and do couples massage. So you can pack it with people. Probably the feature that we get the most oohs and ahs from is right in here in the bathroom. And you'll notice nice space for a double sink, but the best is a slipper tub. So amazing for big bubble baths and just really relaxing, glass of wine, nice music, whatever you like in here. You always have to have a great bedroom as well, obviously. So we have this nice spacious bedroom with a king size bed, a nice comfy bed. And you know, we kind of went with the pipe theme for our closets. That was the trickiest part, actually, in figuring out how to have space in here that was really usable, was what do we do for closet space that doesn't take up too much room? So we just love these, you know, using the piping to hang stuff on has worked great. Because we have curtain walls here, we live in Texas. It gets hot here in the summer. We have a 3-ton mini split that you'll see in a minute, but for circulation, just opening these curtains allows airflow really well, and in addition, having a ceiling fan. So circulating, heating, cooling is really effective in here. Your room number 5 is the dining room. I am a bit of a coffee addict, so we have a little coffee altar here as well, which we love. And then just easy space for eating. This is our 3-ton mini split. Those of you that are curious about heating and cooling in a yurt, works really effectively summer or winter, as well as the yurt has high-tech insulation that really makes a difference. And then last room is a kitchen and laundry room all combined. So in order to save space, we put, instead of on top of each other, we put the washer and dryer beside each other and made it extra countertop that way. Also, this is kind of more European design, so instead of putting a hole through the yurt for the dryer to vent, it actually is a condensing dryer, condenses into the washer which drains down the drain. So that's really practical. We went with induction as well for less fire risk and pretty efficient. Definitely using energy, electric energy makes sense. We produce solar on another part of our property. So electric is a good choice for us. So I want to describe some of the eco features in our yurt. Our mission is to have a green center, a sustainable center. A few things. The front of these cabinets are made from recycled soda bottles, pop bottles, depending where you're listening from, which you wouldn't know. So that's a line IKEA came out with a few summers ago. In here, hidden dishwasher, which is also super quiet and energy efficient, so we love that. A number of the carpets in the yurt are made from recycled soda bottles. One of our favorite things to do when people come in here for the first time is to point out this light fixture and get people to see what they think it's made out of. We get all kinds of interesting guesses. It's actually laser cut cardboard that's been recycled and reused for light fixtures. So we love that. That's a cool feature. In the bathroom, we have a chandelier made from collected sea glass, which is really fun and funky. So conserving space in small spaces is like the number one thing you think about when you're building and designing. Because we're in Texas, we can put some of those things under the yurt. So we did a raised building with room, but it's on pier and beam. So it's less of a footprint on the ground. It's not a concrete slab that this yurt is on. It's on a deck, but underneath is the water heater, is the electrical panel. The outside part to the mini split is out there, so it makes for kind of a cleaner, neater space in here. Storage, really important. Again, lots of cabinets. I actually have, this is probably the most countertop that I have in any kitchen that I've lived in. So there's lots of space here. Every little nook and cranny gets used. So behind the fridge is a little cabinet. That's where the brooms go. Just every little spot. Again, we're in Texas, so it's not hard to have a locker outside with some things, so easy. But it's reminded us to be more minimal, and there's a lot of stuff we just don't need, we just don't use. So it's a space like this is a great opportunity to declutter and remember what's important. When we decided that we wanted to put a yurt on the property, partly was inspired by our architects that helped us design our 20 acres here. They actually live in Eastern Canada, but were asking us, what we thought of Marfa and the yurts, and we're like, what's Marfa? So being new to Texas, we didn't understand some of the creative stuff that goes on in Marfa. We do now. So as we dreamed about having a yurt, we started, just exploring the options, looking at the different producers of those, and went with Colorado yurts. Very well known, especially in this part of the world, for their yurt design. So when we ordered the kit, just to explain kind of what comes and what doesn't, the yurt kit includes the walls, the doors, the windows, the ceiling, the panel at the top, but everything inside the yurt, that's what you do on your own. So, the floors, the plumbing, the ceiling fan, all of that is stuff that we built with our builders and designed on our own. So there's a lot of freedom, a lot of fun floor plans if you're looking for them. This is a 30-foot yurt, it's about 706 square feet, so lots of freedom inside of that. But the actual kit, once the floor is done and the subfloor and the floor is in place, it took about a day and a half to actually put the yurt together in terms of walls, doors, windows, ceiling. So that's pretty amazing, and that's definitely a benefit if you're wanting to put a structure up fairly quickly. They do go together pretty fast with, we had builders that had not done a yurt before who were quite proud of themselves. So that also means the instructions are pretty good that you get from Colorado Yurt. They've got a great little video, and it's not hard to put it together. I wasn't the one 15 feet high putting the roof on, but. So thanks for touring our yurt with us. Obviously we'd love if you came to visit. We're in Wimberley, Texas, just outside of Austin. We're friendly, and we'd love to see you. Thanks.
Thank you.
I hope you enjoyed this video.
Please consider leaving a big thumbs up and sharing with your friends and subscribing to our channel. And we hope to see you guys soon again. See you next time.